you are about to listen to is me, Pastor Michael Bowman, as I think out loud about and try to apply the scripture to anything and everything that comes to mind. This usually happens in my car. So jump in and let's talk. I had a conversation the other day with a young man about the topic of infant baptism. And so it's on my mind a little bit. But one of the things I love most about infant baptism, paedo baptism, is not the actual practice itself, although I think it's glorious and right and biblical. But coming to a place where you understand paedo baptism forces you to read the Bible how it is supposed to be read. You're not able to simply proof text your way to infant baptism. Although I can point to passages in the Bible where children are given the sign of the covenant. I can point to passages where Paul literally says that all of Israel, including the children, were baptized. But you're not able to just simply proof text when it comes to the issue of baptism. And this isn't how the authors of the New Testament read their Bibles. And so it shouldn't be how we read our Bibles, to just proof text our ideas, to just look for a line that says, okay, this is how you baptize. Well, that's not the way that the Bible works. That's not how God has decided to reveal these things. In order to get to the place of infant baptism, you do have to read the Bible very differently than if you're in the place where you would say that it's not right to baptize infants, when you would say that baptism is, you know, a sign of somebody's faith. It's a personal profession of faith and should only be done to those who are adults and repentant. Sometimes when I'm talking to my evangelical or cradle Baptist friends, this has come up a little bit, where they'll say, well, look, it just doesn't say anywhere in the Bible that you should be baptizing infants. And I think, yeah, you are right. I often tell them, yes, you are right about that. Now, what you mean by that is, therefore, the Bible does not teach us to do this. And that's not right. But you are right that there's no direct explicit statement, you should baptize children. There are explicit statements about giving the sign of the covenant to children. But even to get there, you have to have some sense of what exactly a sign of a covenant is, what a covenant is. How does God work through covenants throughout the Bible? You have to have a little bit more of a background and an understanding of the whole of the scripture and how it all fits together and it all works together, and the way that God has progressively revealed things over time and the way all these things fit together, the way that the New Testament authors read the Old Testament. If you simply went through and you saw all the ways that the apostles and the other writers of the New Testament understand and use the Old Testament, you couldn't read the Bible only to proof text, to argue for a particular position. I know that to believe in infant baptism, I am reading the Bible differently. That's absolutely true. That's absolutely right. And I know that the way I used to understand the scripture, the way of saying, well, it doesn't explicitly say this, therefore it is not right. I know that if you read the Bible that way, you cannot come to a place where you would accept paedo baptism. I agree with that. The problem is how you are reading the Bible. And we need to rediscover the beauty of how Scripture is written and how every piece of it fits together. And all of it is summed up in Christ. It finds its end point, its telos, in Christ Himself. And how it all builds upon each other and it references back. And as one of my Hebrew professors call it, it hyperlinks. right? Where each word is connected to each other word in this just beautiful way. And you can figure that out as you try to read the Bible as the biblical authors read the Bible. But a lot of the modern way that we try to understand the text just does not fit this way. It doesn't work. This is one of the reasons, though, why I love being a paedobaptist, not because of the practice itself, but because in order to get to that place, I first had to learn how to read the Bible, and now I see the glory and the richness and the unending majesty of God's Word as He has inspired it, as He has revealed it to us, and the brilliance of it. And it really is astounding.
Hey guys, I hope this has been helpful for you. If it has been, go ahead and rate it, review it, or share it with a friend, especially if you're in La Crosse, Wisconsin, or the surrounding areas. That helps me expand the audience and hopefully increase the impact of these ideas. If you have any questions, thoughts, or concerns on anything that I just talked about, you can reach me at PastorMichaelJBowman@gmail.com. You can find more content from me, as well as information about the church that I pastor at ccc-pca.org. With that, I hope you can enjoy the many blessings of God today. Until next time.